Alright guys, so this is a video, I'm making a reactionary video to this younger gentleman who's been good enough to make this step out and make a video about how you can improve a set of course of competition. And I'm the more I listen to him, the more I am in the choir of Jardier. Good job Jardier on this video, and I hope you don't mind me doing a reactionary video, but I saw he's got 2,700 thumbs up and 49 down and 36,000 and counting views. So it's getting traction, and I think people should go ahead and support this kid on his ideas. And the more that a dev sees this video gets a reaction, maybe they'll do something about some of these things. Let's go ahead and listen to him. I had the subtitles too, but I had the speed up fast, so here we go.
2021, we had a big hard drive. We have 8 terabytes, 10 terabyte hard drives. And we have I can press M on keyboard to save replay. I do it all the time, but can you have a longer?
Hey man, I could guarantee I've heard in Discord about 30 other people just in my little corner of the world. My little racing, which is just one league, and I've heard at least 30 people complain about that replay thing.
Like, I don't know, Aston Martin GT4 Cup only, or Alpine GT series, there's Alpine Esport, Alpine Esport, you gotta fix it. Everybody would have exactly the same setup, exactly the same food, exactly the same function, everything exactly the same. It was so good for local players, and I think it would be so good for overall, because, like, you don't have time to do some play again, and spend hours on perfect setups. I think fixed setup series.
Yes! He said he agrees with me! Nice! And just to let you know, I watched this video like a couple months ago, and I'm... when he first came out with it, and haven't listened to since, so I don't know all the things that he's saying. I'm just winging this. Fix SEDEX. Amen, brother. You got it. Jardier.
Outside the game in Photoshop, you can make completely literate as you want to, and if you put it on the server, you can have actually whatever you want. The Mario's heat card, for example, and so on.
Right.
You have a custom pass in the end, but you have to have that on the server. Like, on the other hand, for example, like iRacing, you have trading pages, and it's so awesome, it's so simple. You just create your own, put it on the internet, put it on the server, downloads, it's so cool. I think it would be amazing somehow. Guys, I'm not devil, because I know I'm so many that people said on my Discord, and I think I totally agree with them, because there was like so many messages, and I really agree with most of it. I feel like a custom image would be awesome. Or if you look at the GT Sport or Forza.
Well, the thing is, Trading Paints, I think, was an external site in iRacing, though. iRacing, as far as I know, did not own Trading Paints. Somebody else made that. So that's if someone wants to make a Trading Paints website, that would work fine. I'm sure that, I think SimGT or one of those things have a thing where you could upload your paints.
They actually have it in game. Like, you can have a car.
I know Race Department does.
So I think as a course I could think, I know it's a limitation of the manufacturers probably and such, but when the others do it as well, you can do so many more. You can do something about it as well. And why we edit with the custom liveries, a fun thing, I totally forgot. Yes, we have a custom liveries, which we can put the files on the server, and then everybody can see it. But those custom liveries are making a bit of a mess on the server. I'm not sure how it actually works, but when somebody has a custom livery, you have it. Well, it lags when people join the server.
Yes, it lags. It doesn't lag, it lags.
Custom liveries. So, together with the balance or performance of the game, would it make it a little smoother? Is it possible?
Yes.
What do you guys think?
Well, the problem is one thing is the cars are too high resolution. The high resolution of the cars is what lags the server, I think.
I know we are bickering about tiny things right now. We are not hating, we're just improving things. But, oh my god, it matters if you stand 10 centimeters to 10 centimeters.
What they should do is they should offer livery templates. So you don't have to search around and sit there trying to put things. The game itself should release templates for each car showing this is the right fender, this is the right left fender, this is where your rear spoiler is, things like that. Just simple templates to make it easier for people to paint their own cars. That should be released by the actual game artists.
Left or twice to the right, or 10 seconds twice in front or rear. Please, just make the box bigger. The pit crew is so lazy. I personally had to fire so many of the pit crews because they are lazy to move and change the car 10 centimeters next to them. So they always put the car and change it down again. I think just make it.
Also, when you go into the pit, and you stop your car, it should automatically turn your engine off. You shouldn't have to sit there and fumble with a keyboard. Or have an option in your options to make it automatic.
So much easier. Is it actually?
Maybe there is already and I just didn't find it, but every time I go to pit, it says you have to turn your engine off and you gotta wait 10 seconds or whatever till the game turns your engine off. It's somewhat irritating.
Feedback from the new players into the game. Make your start awesome. I know you have like a beautiful box that tells you you are in the green area in the formation lap. Don't go to yellow, don't go to red.
Oh, yes, the start.
Stay under 70 km per hour and there we go, green flag. But it's so sensitive to get a penalty or actually sensitive.
Just slow this down.
Save yourself and get the penalty as well, which will ruin your race. I mean, look at iRacing. Like, in iRacing, the only thing the game actually cares is if you don't overtake the guy ahead of you. And that's basically it.
Yeah. Simple.
So, therefore, in like a multi-class race, can start 20 seconds before GTE, because the GTE leader is actually keeping up the field.
Yeah, this just makes too much sense, Jardin.
I mean, of course, stay under a certain speed, like 70 kilometers per hour, but don't make it so oversensitive.
Yes.
We are just players, you know? We are not.
I could not agree more. The start process in every race in Assetto Corso is so incredibly overdone. Like, they just kept it simple. Like, just don't pass the guy in front of you. The whole ghost car things. Oh my god, it's just, they created an absolute mess on starts where there had to be no mess, and made it incredibly arcade-ish to the start. Like, why would they do that? I don't get it. Overcomplicate things. I don't get it. Like, this is a real. Here we go. We're not Super Einstein drivers, it says on the screen. Yes.
And it's always like some people find some bugs into it and they jump the start and.
Jump starts, yes.
Very far back and so on.
Make it simple.
There's always a lot of talk.
Again, right in, I'm right in this guy's choir cheering them on. Things that make just basic common sense things. If you know anything about race games or you've been in race games for years, why would they do this to us? Change it.
There's already a solution. Say sim racing, daily racing, or sim daily races. Daily races and sim grid are like super solutions for racing, daily racing. Then obviously we have a sim racing GP as well. We can join communities and do racing there.
Implemented
in a game, like not. Daily races for sim grid are like awesome, and sim racing GP app as well is super awesome. Thank you for that. Wet weather racing. Okay, if you'd like to have some cool stuff, but I don't speak ring, because wet weather is already amazing in the game. Wet weather is the best ever. There was. A little bit and more. Always more. Like, we gamers.
Okay, so that's basically, you get the gist of his video. You can find it at Jardier. Does a lot of videos and content. And you could go through and read, a lot of people have a lot of good comments. You know, sometimes bad comments are good comments as well. Like, you might think that they're a bad comment, but actually some of the comments that you don't agree with also help shape the game. Biggest issue is the first driver in the list has to join first any race where your driver's swiping. That rule is insane. So there's some decent comments on here. I'm hoping that the dev goes through and reads these comments. I mean, there's a lot of people that, whether you agree with them or not, they're very passionate about this game. And the game needs to make its population to its advantage by appeasing the things they want. So that's it. Just wanted to share his video. And hopefully it brings some more spotlight to his channel and his video, because he really brings out a lot of nice things about the game and tries to help people learn how to play the game better. Please this channel. We really appreciate your coming by and watching the videos. And hope you all have a great day. Sub, thumbs up, and best wishes to you. Bye-bye.